everyone. Hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end. And also, if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we're going to learn a concept which is known as revenue per employee ratio formula. Now, as you can see in the picture over here with the details of the formula, it's quite visible that the revenue per employee formula is your revenue, which is your sales, right? Divide by the current number of the employees which are there in your company. Let's understand the formula in detail. Let's get into the nitty-gritty of the same. See, revenue per employee is important, a very important financial ratio. It is calculated by dividing the revenue of the company that is generated for a specific period by the number of employees in a company. So it helps as a measure of the average. It helps as a average financial productivity, right? So this is the condition. Now, so basically the average financial productivity of each employee of the company, I mean to say. Now the formula is again the same. The revenue per employee is equal to your revenue divided by the current number of employees, right? So this is going to be the formula. Let's understand this with the help of an example to get a more clear picture about the same. Now here we would consider four firms from the same industry for calculating this ratio, and we'll see that how they compare against each other. Let's say there are companies. I'll start writing the headings, the name of the company. They have revenues over here, and this is going to be in dollars. Okay, and they have their number of employees and sales per employee ratio. Now let's begin. Start inputting the data. Let's say the first company name is company ABC, which has a revenue of, let's say, $25,000, number of employee as $80,000 in terms of numbers. The next company is XYZ. Let's say it has $46,000 in terms of revenue, 90,000 employees in the company. And we have the next as EFG company, which has revenue of 23,000, having 1,05,000 employees in their company. And there's last, that's called UEW company, which has 39,000 in terms of revenue and 75,000 as number of employees. Just need to do as simple as that. We just need to make a calculation of this. So it's revenue divided by the sales, the number of employees, revenue divided by the number of employees. If we pull down to Control D, you can see the numbers 0.3125, 0.51121, and 0.52. So compared on the basis of the sales per employee ratio, company UEW 0.52, okay, UEW comes out on the top. Is it a top-notch company, because they have generated the highest number of revenue with less number of employees. So this is a rank. I'm just giving rank of the company. Rank number 1, 2, this is 3, and this is 4. So UEW comes out on the top. Okay, then it is followed by company XYZ, then company ABC, and then EFG. This broadly indicates which company was best able to utilize its employees in terms of productive assets during a specific financial year. And our answer is quite visible. It's UEW, because with less number of employees, they are able to generate higher revenues. Now I'm going to show you the revenue per employee formula in the tech industry. We just saw that, you know, the formula calculation. But if you see for the real life companies like Facebook, Points International, Alphabet, VeriSign, Quora, AutoWeb, and so on and so forth, Twitter, Shutterstock, and so on and so forth, We note that over here, Facebook has the highest sales per employee. The highest sales per employee. It's 1,928,831. So it's basically in points. All of this list above makes more than half a million of sales per year. Almost half a million of sales. Now, interesting to note that Twitter is on the list with $681,914 per employee. Now, how come this is? Is this actually quite interesting? The next set of industry that we are going to look is for the auto parts, the auto manufacturing companies. Now, this is the list of the manufacturing companies, and we have the data for the for these companies. As you can see, we have Ferrari, Ford Motors, General Motors, Tesla, Toyota, Honda, Fiat, Bluebird, Tata Motors, and Gandhi Technologies Group. We note that over here, Ferrari has the highest sales per employee with approximate revenue of $1.1 million per employee. And Fiat, on the other hand, makes around Fiat. On the other hand, they makes $532 per employee. So in general, the top tech companies' revenue per employee is more than the manufacturing companies' revenue per employee. And this is our conclusion right now for the timing enforced. Now, the next set of industry that we are going to look is the banking industry. This is a list of the top banks and their revenue per employee. We have UBS, Westpac, Bank of Montreal, ING, Royal Bank of Canada, Butterfield, JP Morgan, Bankem, Credit Suisse, Westpac, and so on and so forth. So now overall banks also makes far lesser sales per employee as compared to the tech industry. So tech is still holding its top-notch position. It's not leaving. And JP Morgan makes makes an annual revenue of $403,485 per employee. Now, we have seen the examples of so many companies, right? Now, as you can see a graph over here of Facebook, Google, Amazon, right? This is the ratio, basically. The ratio, this ratio basically helps to determine how productively a company is able to utilize its employees and contribute to its business growth. So if a company has, let's say, higher revenue per employee formula, it means that the company is generally doing well and trying to make optimum utilization of the available manpower in the form of its employees. However, the labor intensive companies typically tend to have lower ratios as compared to those which require a lesser amount of labors, you can see. So this is why generally the ratio is employed to compare the performance of the company within the industry. Now, when we compare to this per employee of Facebook, Google, Amazon, we know that Facebook over here has the highest level of the employee at 1.929 million per employee, and Google has, and everything is terms of million, Google has this employee of 1.475 million, and Amazon's revenue is at 392,034 per employee.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.